Hi, in this video, I'll show you how we can plan or budget for a new business cycle using ValQ. So in this case, I've taken a P&L model that has the net sales, cost of sales, expenses, and so forth to arrive at the net profit. And the data that I'm having is the actuals and budget for the fiscal year 2020. And let's say we want to build a baseline budget for the year 2021. Now, the data set that I've taken is in the format of a crosstab, which is very popular in Excel. I have the, let's say, the 8 months of actuals for the till the month of August 2020, and then the forecast from September through December, followed by the 12 months of budget for the entire year. Now, if you're used to working in Power BI, you can also go the traditional Power BI format where you have actuals in one column, a forecast and budget in additional columns, and your entire time period captured in a single column with all the months where you model time intelligence appropriately. Now, ValQ can support both these formats, and I'm just laying it out there before we proceed with creating a baseline budget for the year 2021. Now, to do that, I have to go and click on the Plan tab. And the first thing that it'll do is to ask me to lock the model so that the relationships between the KPIs don't get changed. So once I do that, I have a couple of options where to start with. And typically companies like to start with the most recent actuals. In a later video, I'll also show you how we can perform zero-based budgeting using ValQ, where you pretty much start off with an empty template. Now, I'm just going to start off with actuals, and let me name it My Budget Baseline 2021. And then I will just click on Submit. Now, here I have the entire actuals for the year 2020, and now we can start working on the changes. Now, I have the whole hierarchy here. I have the total for the year, and also have the 12 months from Jan through December. Now, let's say for 2021, the sale of goods is expected to increase by 10%. Now, to incorporate that, I'm going to double click on this and then say add 10% to this number. Now, I can do these changes right here in the cell, or I can also do it here in the formula bar, pretty much like Excel. So once I do this for the year, I need to spread it across all the 12 months, and I can do an equal spread. But in this case, I want to maintain seasonality, so I'm just going to go and click on a weight-based spread. So I just click on this and then preview that we are going to increase it by 10%, and I'm just going to go ahead and click on Apply. And as soon as I do this, it's going to roll all the changes up to the top. And if I come down, it is also going to update the way in which we calculate our interest and taxes and the gross profit and so forth. So let me go back up, and at any point in time, I can mouse over any of these items and see what was the older value and how it got changed to the newer value. Now let's take the case of services, right? And unlike goods, we are not going to do a percentage increase, but an absolute increase. So let's say this is going to increase by, let's say, 22 million. So I can just go and type in plus 22M. And I can also reduce it, say minus 6 million and so forth. So once I do this, even in this case, I'll do a weight-based allocation, and then quickly that's being spread equally to all the months. And now let's say in the case of others, I don't want to increase it or decrease it by an absolute number or a percentage, but let's say I just want this to be 84 million. And this time I want this to be spread equally across all these months, in which case I'm going to go and click on equals, and you can do an equal distribution of 7 million for each of these months. So there are several intelligent allocations that you can do in ValQ using this editable table or a grid. Let me just show you a few more examples. I'll come down and I actually want to show you something to do with the rent and facilities here. So let's say the rent on purpose, I've taken existing data which is not allocated equally. Now before, so we have a scenario where the lease is up for renewal in the month of March or April 2021. Now before I go and factor in the lease, I want to redistribute this value equally across all these months. And without making any changes here, I'm just going to go and click on equals, and the values get redistributed equally across all these months. Now, let's say from the month of April, I'll just double click this, and then I'm going to add 4,500 so that it rounds off approximately to 40K. So once I do that, I just go and click on this copy to icon. And what happens is from the month of April all the way through the end of the year, it increases uniformly to 40K. I can also do other types of distributions. For example, let's take telephone expenses. Let me spread it equally. And then let's say for some reason, and this is a scenario that you encounter when you're launching a new product and so forth, but I'm just going to go and apply that method for the telephone expenses. So you can also do a trend-based increase where you can say, hey, you know, I want to increase it month over month by 2% or 3%, right? And this 3% incremental growth will happen month over month. And once I do this, you will see that 32K slowly increased to 33, 34. And these are all scale values, but you can see the absolute values in the pop-up, which is somewhere close to 37. I'm not able to read it very clearly here. I think it's an decrease of 3,786, but it's somewhere close to 33K. And you can see that increase happening month over month proportionately. So every month, it's going to take the previous month's value and increase it by 3%. The other thing I can do is also a driver-based allocation, right? So let's say we want to allocate power based on, let's say, our labor cost or how many units we have manufactured. So let me show you how to do that. I can go and click on weight. And instead of allocating it based on the same node, I can go and click on, let's say, labor, you know, which is a proxy for how much we are manufacturing in this case. So I'm making a lot of assumptions here, but I just want to show you different ways in which you can do allocation, spreading, and distributions. So once I click on this, the values are going to get allocated based on the trend for the labor cost or the headcount if you have it in the model. So like this, you can use several allocation, spreading, and distribution methods using ValQ. And I also have the ability to go and make some comments. So let's say I can go and select any particular node and then click on this comment and then type in my comment so that when others look at the model, they will see why you have actually changed something. And the other thing I didn't show you is you can also go and lock certain nodes. So I just go and click on this hold icon. And as soon as I do that, you will see this small lock icon appearing for the months of Jan through April. And let's say you can now go and increase, let's say by 40K. And all that increase is going to be passed on only from the months of May through December. And you can use this as well. And the last thing that I want to show you is you can also look at the allocation history. And here you click on this and then it will show you a history of all the allocations that we did so far. And it also allows you to retrace the steps. For example, I can go back to the changes that I did in services and just click on this and it will recover the model back to that particular step. And finally, I can also create a copy of this baseline here. So when I click on new series in additions to actuals and budget, I'm also going to see my budget baseline 2021 and create an additional series based on that. And once I do this, I'll also be able to go and compare this on the simulate and the analysis tab. So here I can compare my new baseline for the budget against the actuals for the current year. And I can also go and perform variance analysis based on the series that we just created. So I hope you enjoyed this video. So go ahead and download the file from our website and which we'll be publishing along with this video. And if you have any questions, do not hesitate to reach out to us. Thank you for watching this video. Have a great day.